President Muhammadu Buhari Tuesday in Abuja said harder times await bandits whose disruptive activities have brought sorrow to Nigerians, kept many away from their means of livelihood, and heightened insecurity in parts of the country. The president, who stated this when he received a delegation of eminent and respected citizens of Niger State, led by Governor Abubakar Sani Bello in State House Abuja, said the activities of the bandits had forced many to abandon their farms and homes. He said he was taken aback by what is happening in the northwest and other parts of the country, noting that during the campaigns, Boko Haram was the only known challenge. He, however, expressed surprise at the current development, adding that it is not ethnicity or religion, rather it is an evil plan against the country. President Buhari said the onslaught of the bandits had also affected agricultural output in some parts of the country, in spite of the favorable weather for farming, because many farmers were attacked and others had to stay away for safety. The president said the poverty level in the country will be significantly controlled by diversifying into agriculture instead of the heavy reliance on oil, urging more Nigerians to take up agriculture. President Buhari said discovery of oil and gas reserves in Chad Basin, Benue Trough, and Bida, and some parts of Bauchi and Gombe will further boost current efforts to strengthen the Nigerian economy. He advised leaders in the Niger Delta to cancel those who blow up pipelines, resulting in spillage that affect farming and farmlands, noting that the loss had always been collective, sometimes turning hard-working farmers to victims. From Abuja, I'm Festus Ejiroga Nefifen for Ben Television.
Person of the House of Representatives, Ben Kalu, disclosed that the general insecurity in the country is giving members of the House sleepless nights. The spokesperson, while briefing newsmen at the National Assembly complex, said the House will consider a legislative instrument to control this situation. He said that the House, which just resumed from 6-week break, will look at the issue confronting the country, particularly security. According to him, the recent report we are getting shows that the police is capable of handling our internet security. We are going to use legislative intervention to support them demand and all other role players within the armed forces. The Trade Union Congress of Nigeria, TUC, has urged the federal government to reduce the cost of governance to allow growth in the nation's economy. Its President Kudri Olaleye and Secretary General Musa Lawal Ozigi made the call in a statement made available to journalists in Lagos. They spoke while reacting to the plan by the Revenue Mobilization Allocation and Fiscal Commission to review the remuneration of political office holders. The union leader said that the pay rise for politicians will increase political violence and poverty. The Revenue Mobilization Allocation and Fiscal Commission Chairman Elias Mba has said that the review of salary and emolument of political office holder was in view with the current economic realities. Mba said that at the conclusion of the review process, the entitlement of political office holder might either go up or down. The TUC leader also urged the federal government not to borrow money to run the economy.
Thank you.
Nigerian Minister of Agriculture and Rural Development, Sambo Nanono, said Nigeria will hopefully begin exporting rice to other countries in the next 2 years. Nanono hinted this in a statement issued on his behalf by Theodore Ogazishi, the Director of Information in the Ministry. The statement quoted the minister saying that the border closure by the federal government has resulted in increased output by local rice farmers and millers across the country. Nanono said this during a working visit to Lagos. The minister further said that most rice producers have stocked rice in various silos that might serve the country for the next 6 months, such that before the stock is finished, dry season rice will be harvested. Nanono said that all year-round rice farming has made the country a force to be reckoned with in rice production. President Muhammad Buhari has written to the Nigerian Senate seeking the recognition of the interim management of the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, till the forensic audit of the account and activity of the commission, which he ordered earlier in 2019, is completed. Buhari, in a letter which was read on the floor of the Senate upon resumption by President of the Senate, Ahmad Lawa, asked the lawmakers to recognize NDDC Interim Management Committee, named by the Minister of Niger Delta, Godswill Akpabio. The President in the letter said the IMC of the Commission will function until forensic audit of the Commission is completed. He approved that the Board of Niger Delta Development Commission be recomposed and inaugurated after the forensic audit of the organization.
Tungwi Senate President, appointment of NDDC Board. I write to intimate the Senate of Developments concerning the appointment of the Board of Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC. The Senate may wish to note that after the dissolution of the Board of the NDDC, an interim management team was set up to manage the affairs of the Commission before a new board was composed and sent for Senate confirmation. The Senate is invited to note that while the process of composition and Senate confirmation of the appointment of the board was ongoing, I had directed that the forensic audit of the commission be carried out, which is being overseen by the constituted interim management team. Based on this, and in order to allow for uninterrupted process of the forensic investigation, the board appointment confirmed by the Senate has to be put on hold to allow the interim team continue to manage the commission pending the outcome of the forensic audit. Thereafter, a new board of the commission will be recomposed for confirmation by the Senate. Please accept the single Senate President the assurances of my highest consideration. Yours sincerely, Muhammadu Buhari.
The board, which was screened by Senate on October 30, 2019, has not been inaugurated by the president, a situation that has raised a lot of dust from many stakeholders and groups in the Niger Delta region. The president also sought the confirmation of Captain Musa Nuhu as Director General, Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority, and Kingsley Obiora as Deputy Governor of Central Bank.
Dear the Distinguished Senate President, request for confirmation of appointment of Captain Musa Shuaibu Nuhu as Director General for the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority, NCAA. Pursuant to Section 8, Part 4 of the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority Establishment, etc. Act, I hereby write to request for confirmation by the Senate the appointment of Captain Musa Shuaibu Nuhu as the Director General of the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority. Captain Musa Shuaibu Nuhu is a reputable airline pilot and aviation safety expert with well over 30 years of cognate working experience in the aviation industry. A copy of his detailed curriculum vitae is attached herewith. In view of the strategic importance of the NCAA as a regulator of the civil aviation industry, I wish to request for the expeditious consideration and confirmation of Captain Musa Shuaibu Nuhu as the Substantive Director General of NCAA. Please accept the single Senate President the assurances of my highest consideration. Yours sincerely, Muhammadu Buhari. Letter from Mr. President, confirmation of appointment. In accordance with the provisions of Section 8, Subsection 1 and 2 of the Central Bank of Nigeria CBN Establishment, etc., Act 2007, I have the pleasure to present Dr. Kingsley Isitua Obiora for confirmation as Deputy Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria. Find attached a copy of his curriculum vitae. While looking forward for your usual expeditious consideration, please accept, Mr. Senate President, the assurances of my highest regards. Yours sincerely, Muhammadu Buhari.
Other letter from Mr. President was those for the consideration to appoint Professor Adeolu Akande as the Chairman, Nigerian Communication Commission, NCC, and Ushe Nwande as member.
Bavidi Luxury Hotel, the newest home away from home in the Nigerian hospitality industry. 10 minutes only from the local and international airports is the perfect spot for your relaxation whenever you are in Lagos. 24-hour non-stop electricity, cozy and colorful rooms, Wi-Fi internet connection, and flat-screen cable television. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, our exquisite restaurant and full bar are simply second to none in taste and style. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, we are located at the posh serene neighborhood in the Ikeja Business District. Your satisfaction is our first concern, so we train our staff to be professional and personable. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, number 20 Moshood Abiola Crescent, Ikeja, Lagos. Telephone plus 234-1291-7929 plus 234-708-287-7512. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, the new home away from home.
The President of the Senate, Ahmad Lawa, said the legislative arms of government is unhappy with the degeneration of the security situation in the country. Speaking at the media briefing with a member of the Senate press corps, the President of the Senate said that the National Assembly will work with the executive arm of government to tackle the unending insecurity challenges ravaging the country. He said it is unfortunate that Nigerians have been under continuous attack by insurgents, kidnappers, bandits and robbers that has worsened the security situation in the country. Lawa said there's no pretense that the current security apparatus in the country cannot curtail the spate of insecurity, violent and premeditated killings, hence the need for complementary arrangement to secure life and property.
And most importantly here is to look into the issue of security that is bedeviling this country. Apparently, and obviously, all hands must be on deck to ensure that we bring back a better security situation like we had before. Presently, the story is not good. In many areas, you have so much happening that is destabilizing our communities, killing of people, and we believe that we owe Nigerians the responsibility to intervene, to work together with the executive arm of government, actually to work together with the other tiers of government, the states and even the local governments, to ensure that we change the way we approach the security issues in this country. Apparently, the system has not been working effectively and efficiently, and we have to do something. And this time around, there shouldn't be backpassing. We have to be forthright. We have to say it as it is, and we have to do it as is required as a government, because we just cannot play politics with this. Lives are at stake, and therefore the Senate will take a very definite position on how security in this country should be. I believe personally that we should restructure the the security architecture, the present system does not appear to give us the kind of outcome that we need. And of course, whether it's the federal government or the state or the traditional rulers or local governments or what have you, the purpose should be to secure the lives and property of Nigerians, and we'll do that.
Also, the National Assembly, according to Lawa, we, as a matter of urgency, prioritize the consideration of the petroleum industry bill alongside reform of the Electoral Act before end of 2020.
The PIB that has defied passage, we want to break that jinx. Whatever the mystery, we are determined to ensure that we pass the PIB before the end of this year by the grace of God. The PIB is so important because until you are able to pass that bill or bills, whichever happens, you cannot attract investments into the oil and gas industry. In the last 10 years, there has not been any investment in the oil and gas sector in Nigeria. That is so important because we have lost so much. And if we pass, and by the grace of God we will, the enormous advantages, the enormous benefits will be important in catapulting the economy of Nigeria to the level that we desire, to the level the Nigerians need. We are also not oblivious of the need and necessity, really, to ensure that we amend the Electoral Act. We have had the 2019 elections. We had some other rerun or by elections. Actually, even on Saturday, last Saturday, we had elections in about 11 states. 28 elections were held. There must be lessons from those elections, from 2019 to the elections of Saturday, last Saturday. So we should be looking at where there are our challenges and what we need to do to provide legislative interventions so that we have better election processes and procedures going forward.
In Abuja, Muyiwa Bamdele reporting.